Sorry. Let us start our seminar. Our speaker Valery Bardakov, with the title Young-Baxter Equations, Q-Braces and Relative Rota-Baxter Operators, please.
Okay, thank you for invitation. I am very glad to give a talk on your seminar. As I understand, your seminar is young but very popular. And today I will speak about some on the first view different things. At first, Young-Baxter equation. I will speak about set theoretic solutions for the Young-Baxter equation. Also, I will speak about skew braces. Skew braces is algebraic system with two binary algebraic operation and Rota-Baxter operators and so-called relative Rota-Baxter operators. Rota-Baxter operator on the Lie algebra, for example, or in on associative algebra is a classical object, but Rota-Baxter operator on groups and relative Rota-Baxter operators on group it's new object and it's interesting. And all these things are connected. And today I think that the main purpose of my talk to explain connection between these things and the I want to introduce some results which we have found with my colleagues Tatiana Kozlovskaya, Pavel Sokolov, Ksenia Zimereva, and Matvey Zonov. We have found this result during a so-called student workshop during this summer, where we discuss with people some interesting things and have found some results. This is the main purpose of my talk. And sorry, what is problem? My talk, it's possible to divide on five parts. In the first part, I introduce Young-Baxter equation, Braid equation. And on the second part, I recall the definition of skew braces, give examples of skew braces, and explain connection of skew braces with Young-Baxter equation. After this, we will speak about Rota-Baxter operators on group and relative Rota-Baxter operators on groups. And at the final part, I will speak about post-group and Young-Baxter equation. First part, Young-Baxter equation and Braid equation. The definition is the following. Suppose that we have some non-empty set X and a map R from X squared to X squared is said to be a set theoretic solution, or we will say simply solution for the Young-Baxter equation. It's if the following equality true: R12 composition of operators R12, R13, R23, it's the product of these operators, but in opposite direction. R23, R13, and R12. Where RAJ, it's the operator from X cubed to X cubed, which acts as R on the I-th and J-th component, and 3 as an identity map on the third component. And the simplest example of a solution for the Young-Baxter equation, let us consider some set X and define the map P, which is permutation of two components. P of XY is equal to YX. And it's easy to see that this is solution for the Young-Baxter equation. The second equation, it's the so-called Braid equation. Suppose that we have a map R from x square to x square. And this is solution for the Young-Baxter equation. And let us consider the operator S, which a product of two operators. First operator A, and the second one, its permutation P. When it's easy to see that this operator S gives a solution for the so-called Braid equation. Braid equation has this form S12, S21, S12. It's equal to S2, S1, S2. Where S1 is the operator which acts on the x cubed to x cubed, and x as S on the first and the second component S as identity map on the third component. And S2 acts as identity on the third component and S on the second and on the third components. And you can see that this equation look like as a Braid equation. Braid equation is the famous equation in the definition of Braid group, and Braid group is connected with the knot theory. You know that in the knot theory, the famous Rademeister theorem says the following. Suppose that you have two knots, and these knots are equivalent if and only if it's possible to transform diagram of one this node to the diagram of the second node using three Rademeister move. First Rademeister move, second, and the third. But for us, it's more interesting the third Rademeister move. You can see this is move on this picture. If we have three acts, then you can transform this x in the low position. I will say only some words about connection of the Young-Baxter equation with topological knot theory. And now let us say about solution of the Young-Baxter equation. Suppose that A x y is the pair of function sigma y x and tau x y. Is a solution for the Young-Baxter equation. I will write these components in this form, sigma y and tau x, but you can consider this only as two functions which depend on two variables, x and y. And we will say that this solution is a non-generate solution if sigma x and tau x are invertible for all x from x capital. First definition, the second one is the square free. If a of xx is equal to xx for any x, when we say that this solution is the square free. Also, we will say that this solution is involutive if a square is equal to identity map. And also, we will say that solution is elementary if tau x is identity map or sigma x is identity map. We introduce four types of solutions. And now we are going from solution for the Young-Baxter equation to some algebraic system. We will say that groupoid is a non-empty set with one binary algebraic operation. And by analogy, we will call a two-groupoid is a non-empty set with two binary algebraic operation. And suppose that we have X and A, its solution for the Young-Baxter equation on the non-empty set X, and A is defined by the following map. A x y is the pair sigma y and tau x. In this case, we can construct two groupoid. Groupoid with the basis set x and with two operations, point and star, where these operations are defined by the following rule. x point y is sigma y of x, and y star x is the tau x of I. Hence, if we have solution for some Young-Baxter equation, we can construct some two group of it. Not difficult to prove the next proposition. Let X with two operation be a two groupoid, and A is a solution for the Young-Baxter. Suppose that X is two groupoid, and A is some map from X square to X square, which is defined by the formula. Axy is the pair where first component is the first operation, x point y, and the second one, y star x, is the second operation for elements xy in the x capital. When this pair defined a solution of the Young-Baxter equation, if and only if the following free equality hold. But you can see that with unusual axiom, it's strange. We cannot say in general case about nothing about this algebraic system. And usually people go in opposite direction. People take some algebraic system, which we know, for example, group, vector space, algebra, and so on. And using the operation on this algebraic system, try to construct solution for the Young-Baxter equation on this algebraic system. This is the general approach. Also, I will say about some words about connection of Braid equation and the not invariant. We can formulate the next proposition. Suppose that we have X and R is a non-degenerate square-free solution for the Young-Baxter equation. When the two groupoid X with two operations defines a not invariant. If you remember the famous Rademacher moves, we have three type of Rademacher move, and to keep our algebraic system under this Rademacher move, it's need to have non-degeneracy and square-free solution. For example, group of node, quantal of node, biquantal of node can be constructed using this. And the second part, skew brace. We understand that we can construct some algebraic system using the solution for the Young-Baxter equation, but it's difficult to study this algebraic system. And we use another direction. Skew braces are generalization of braces, way you introduce in the paper of Cornieri and Vendramin. And this algebraic system was defined for studying non-involutive solution to the Young-Baxter equation. And now I give a definition. A two-groupoid A with two binary operations, point and circle, is called skew left brace if A with point and A with circle are group, and for all A, B, and C holds the next equality. You can see that it looks like as a distributivity. If you remove this element A in minus one, then you will have distributivity. Here, A in power minus 1 is inverse element in the group A with point. This is the definition. And by the way, we defined left brace. It's possible to consider right brace if you take the product B point C and the circle A. It's possible to rewrite this axiom, and we you get the skew right brace. And since we have skew brace, it's possible, of course, to define a braces. Braces were defined by Rump in the 2007. A skew brace is called a brace if the first group A with operation point is abelian group. In fact, brace come from the ring theory. Suppose that you have some ring with two operations, and you can define some operation circle using these operations. And if this operation is a group, then you get a brace. And brace is used for studying for involutive solutions to the Young-Baxter equation. For example, suppose that we have a group G, and you can define the second operation circle. You put A circle B that it's equal to our original operation point. Or you can put A circle B as opposite operation, it's equal B point A. In this case, we get, of course, skew brace, but we shall call these skew braces by trivial skew braces. And the first non-trivial example, suppose that we have infinite cyclic group with operation plus, when we can define the new operation circle by the following group, A circle B, it's A plus minus 1 in the power of A multiplied to B for element AB. And it's not difficult to see that we get a brace. And because the first operation is commutative. If we have some skew brace, then it's possible to construct the next map. The map so-called lambda map. Lambda acts from the group G with operation circle to the group of automorphism G with point. We can define this by the following manner. Elements A goes to automorphism lambda of A, and we will write with lambda sub A, where this operation, this map, it's defined by the formula. Lambda A of B, it's the product A minus 1, it's inverse element in G with point, and multiply to the product A circle B. And this map, it's a group homomorphism. But have a look, it's homomorphism, in fact, between different groups. The first group is group G with operation circle, but the second group is group of automorphism G with points. And if we have this homomorphism, we can, it's not difficult to write the following formula. A circle B, it's product A multiplied to lambda AB. Hence, if we have a group G with point, and if we have with map lambda, we can define the second operation circle. And also, we can define the operation A point B. And we will call this map is a lambda map. And we see that if we want to construct a skew brace, we can construct on the group G, some lambda. Now I explain the connection between skew braces and the set theoretic solution for the Young-Baxter equation. The next theorem was proved in the paper of Guarneri and Vendramin, and this theorem say the following. Suppose that we have a skew left brace, G with two operations, point and circle, when the map S, which send G square to G square, what is defined by the following group, SAB, it's the pair of this form, lambda ab is our element, and now we have lambda sub a of b with bar. Bar means that we take inverse element in the group G with the circle. And we consider the circle of circle operation of A and circle of B. And this is solution for the Braid equation on the set G. Hence, we can formulate the next problem. If we want to find solution for the Braid equation, or it's the same what a solution for the Young-Baxter equation, it's need to construct skew braces on our set X. This is connection of a Young-Baxter equation with skew braces. And now I explain some possibilities for construction of skew braces. The first one, it's connect with regular subgroup and with column of a group G. I recall that if we have a group G, then we can define its holomorph, it's denoted by whole of G. It's the same direct product of the group of automorphism G and the group G. Here, group of automorphism of course acts on the group G. And we can define the product, the pair FA, multiply to product GB, where F and G are automorphism, and A and B are element of our group G, and this product is equal to the next pair. First component, it's the product of two automorphisms, F and G, and the second circle component, we take the image of element B, under the action of automorphism F and multiply to element A. This is the definition of holomorph, and any subgroup of holomorph acts on group G by the following group, where FA acts on B, it's equal to this element. This is the definition, and now we I give the next definition. This is the definition of regular subgroup. The definition is the following. A subgroup H of holomorph is said to be regular if for each element A from G will exist a unique U pair F and X. Pair is element from X such that the image of A under F multiplied to X is equal to the unit element. Hence, we have some set of subgroups in the holomorph, and we call these subgroups are regular. And now we can formulate some possibility for construction of regular subgroups. Suppose that we have a skew-skew-lab brace, then we can define the set of pair lambda A. Lambda A, it's automorphism of the group G, and A, it's element of G. If we have a skew brace, then the set of this pair is a regular subgroup of holomorph. Also, we know the following assumption. Conversely, if G with point is a group and H is a regular subgroup of holomorph, then we can construct a skew left brace such that second group, G with circle, it's isomorphic to H, where operation circle is defined by the rule A circle B, it's element of this type A multiplied to F of B. To construct this pair, we take the element A and take its pre-image of projection P2 on the second component. Hence, we have found connection between scalar braces and regular subgroups of Golomov. It was constructed some algorithm in the paper of Guarnieri and Vendramin, which give a possibility to describe regular subgroups for groups of small orders. And in our paper with Mikhail Nishidim and Manoj Yedav, we improved this algorithm and computed the number of non-isomorphic left braces and skew left braces of order up to 868. Except certain cases. For example, the case the order of 32, because it's possible to prove that the number of skew braces more than 1 million, million of order 2 in power 5. And these skew braces more than 20 millions of order 3 in power 5. You can see that the number of braces bigger than the number of groups. And now the third part is Rota-Baxter operators on group. I will give the definition. This definition was introduced in the paper of Kao, Lang, and Schenk, and the definition is the following. Let G be a group when map B from G to G is called a Rota-Baxter operator if and only if the following equality true. Have a look. Here in the left-hand side, we have the product image of element G multiplied to image of element H, and it's equal to the image of B of this product. Have a look here. Here you can see the element G, and G is multiplied to element A, to element which is conjugated to H by element B of G. This is the definition, and a group with this Rota-Baxter operator is called a Rota-Baxter group. And I can explain why this definition was introduced. One of the main results from this paper of three authors is the following. Suppose that we have Lie group G with this operator Rota-Baxter operator B. When you can construct a Lie algebra, and in this case, Rota-Baxter operator on groups goes to the Rota-Baxter operator on Lie algebra. But Rota-Baxter operator on Lie algebra connect with the linear solution for the Young-Baxter equation on the sum side. On the other side, before, Rota-Baxter operators defined independently on Young-Baxter equation. For example, the famous formula of integrability by parts, it's only definition of Rota-Baxter operator on associative algebra. I give some example. The first simplest examples are the following. For arbitrary group G, we can define the map, I will denote it by B with zero, which sends any element G to unit element in the group. When this is a Rota-Baxter operator on group G, on the other side, we can construct the operator which sends any element G to inverse element G minus 1. And also, it's not easy to check that this is a Rota-Baxter operator on G. And non-trivial example, suppose that G be a group with a Rota-Baxter operator B. If G is abelian, then you can see that the g circle h is equal to g point h. Hence, in this case, you can see that Rota-Baxter operator on abelian group, it's endomorphism on this group. And in this case, we have full description of Rota-Baxter operators. And connection between group and Rota-Baxter operators. The following proposition, it is true. Suppose that we have a Rota-Baxter group. It's a group with a Rota-Baxter operator. When, if we consider the product of element circle, G circle H, you remember that this product you seen in the definition of Rota-Baxter operator. When this circle define a group on the set G. This is the first property. And the second one is that the operator B is a Rota-Baxter operator, not only on the group G with point, but also it's a Rota-Baxter operator on group G with circle. And the next property that the map B from the group G with circle to group G with point, it's a homomorphism of Rota-Baxter group. This is important property of Rota-Baxter operators, and this property is similar to the properties of Rota-Baxter operators for Lie algebras. And now we can formulate the main problem. Suppose that we have a group G. Find all Rota-Baxter operators which is it possible defined on this group. Now we know only the full description for the abelian group. On the abelian group, any Rota-Baxter operator is a homomorphism. But in our group, it's problem. In particular, it's problem to find Rota-Baxter operators on free non-abelian group. Of course, we know some construction of Rota-Baxter operators on non-abelian group, but in particular, we don't know the answer on the next natural question. Suppose that we have map from a basis of our free non-abelian group to free group. Is it possible to extend this map to a Rota-Baxter operator on this group? We studied these questions with Всеволод Губарев in the next two papers, but of course, the full answer, it's difficult to find full answer on these questions. Some words about Rota-Baxter operators on abelian group. We seen that if G is an abelian group, when B is a Rota-Baxter operator on G, if and only if B is an endomorphism on G. Also, it's not difficult to prove the following proposition. Suppose that G will be a Rota-Baxter group, and B is an automorphism of G. In this case, G is abelian group. Hence, if you take some group and you want to construct some non-abelian group and you want to construct a Rota-Baxter operator, you can take a map which is not an automorphism. This is the problem for construction of operators of this type. And the second part, if H is an abelian subgroup of a group G, when any homomorphism or anti-homomorphism of B into H is a Rota-Baxter operator. And now I also explain some construction which give possibility to construct Rota-Baxter operator. Suppose that G is a product of two subgroups. G is a product of H and A. In this case, we say that G is factorizable by H and N. L and this expression g is equal to h and product h a is called a factorization of g. Also, if the intersection of h and l is the unit element, then we will call such factorization by exact factorization. And if h and l are proper subgroups of G, it means that they are not equal to unit subgroup and not equal to G. And in this case, we will call a factorization G proper factorization. This is the definition. And now the next construction you can find in the paper of these three authors. And this is example of the following type. Let G be a group with exact factorization. G is equal to the product H and L. When the map B from G into G, what is defined by the rule, B sends the product H L, of course, H small in H capital L, small in L capital, it's equal to L inverse when this map is a Rota-Baxter operator on G. In this case, we will call this Rota-Baxter operator explicit Rota-Baxter operator. And also, it's possible to construct some generalization of Rota-Baxter operators on exact factorization. And it's possible to prove the next proposition. Suppose that we have a semi-direct product. G is a semi-direct product of two subgroups. And C be a Rota-Baxter operator on H. In this case, the map B from G to G, which acts by the following formula, B of H L is equal to C of L, is a Rota-Baxter operator on G. This is some construction. And now I formulate simple but very important property which give connection of Rota-Baxter groups and skew level trees. We prove this proposition with Всеволод Губарев, and this proposition is the following. Suppose that we have a Rota-Baxter group G with operation point and with Rota-Baxter operator B. And let us define the operation circle sub B. It's the product of G and H. What is the product elements of this type? As we know, this is group operation. And more, in this case, if we take G with these two operations, then we get a skew left brace. This gives some connection of skew left brace and Rota-Baxter groups. And not difficult to prove, the next corollary. Suppose that we have a Rota-Baxter group when if image of B lies in the center of G, when the skew left brace is a trivial one. It means in this case that the operation circle B is equal to the operation points. Hence, in this case, it's not interesting to study skew braces. And we will denote with skew left brace, which we constructed using the Rota-Baxter operator by G of B. And now some example. You remember that we constructed two type of Rota-Baxter operators, B0 and B minus one on arbitrary group. And it's interesting to understand which skew braces it possible to construct using this operator. And in the first case, skew brace G of B0, which we construct using Rota-Baxter operator B0, it's the trivial skew left brace with equal operations. The same similar situation in the second case. If we consider the skew brace, which we construct using the skew brace B minus one, when we construct the second operation X circle, what is opposite to the first operation. In this case, you see that it's not interesting to study with skew braces. And now you remember that if we have a skew-left brace, then we can construct a lambda map. And in the case of Rota-Baxter skew brace, we can see that lambda A of B, it's the element of the following form, B of A, B, and B of A inverse. It means that the automorphism lambda sub A, it's the inner automorphism, what is conjugation by element B A inverse. It's interesting question. Is every skew left brace induced by a Rota-Baxter operator? Because we shown that if we have Rota-Baxter operator on group, we can construct some skew left brace. But it's interesting what can we do in opposite direction. And we prove the next theorem that every skew left brace can be embedded into a Rota-Baxter group. But in general case, this Rota-Baxter group is bigger than our original group. Now I will say about so-called lambda homomorphic skew-left brace. We introduced these braces in our paper with Mikhail Nishidim and Manoj Yadav, and with definition in the following. A skew left brace G with two operation circle and point and circle is said to be lambda homomorphic skew left brace if the lambda map from G with points goes to automorphism G with point, what is defined by the following group is a homomorphism. What is the problem? Suppose that you have construct a some skew brace with properties what one group has one properties and the second one has another properties. You know, we know a lot of problem of this type, but it's difficult to define the next group because to construct lambda, we can take G with circle and map to automorphism of G with point. But now we say that skew brace is lambda homomorphic skew brace if we map lambda from G with point to a group of all G with point is homomorphism. Hence, in this case, we have group G, we can define a homomorphism lambda, we can define a homomorphism onto the generators of this group, and we can construct some skew brace. This is another approach for constructing of skew braces. Also we can description of lambda homomorphic skew-left braces as in the case of arbitrary skew braces. We proved the next theorem. Suppose that G be a group and lambda from G to O G be a homomorphism. Here on G we have only one operation. And this homomorphism from G with point to the automorphism of G with the same operation. When the set H sub lambda, it's the set of pair lambda A and A, where lambda A is automorphism, A and some element, is a subgroup of Golomar if and only if the set of elements of this type lies in the kernel of lambda. Moreover, if H of lambda is a subgroup, then it's regular subgroup. And therefore, we get SQ left braids where the second operation circle is defined by the following group. Hence, we have a good possibility for construction of lambda homomorphic SQ braces. Now, because we know if you have skew brace, then we can construct a solution for the Young-Baxter equation. And it's possible to prove the next theorem. If we have a Rota-Baxter group, then we can define the map lambda, such that lambda A of B is the element of this type. And in this case, the map A from G square to G square, which acts by the formula A of AB, it's equal to this pair. Here you can see the conjugation of element A by this product, and the second component lambda A of B is a non-generate solution to the Young-Baxter equation. And if and this solution is involutive if and only if our group G is commutative, AB product is equal to B. And now I am going for definition of relative Rota-Baxter operators on groups. Relative Rota-Baxter operators on group are generalization of usual Rota-Baxter operators, and these operators will introduce in the next paper, if a paper of Zhang, Sheng, and Zhu, it's possible to find it in archive, and the definition is the following. Let G and H be a group, and we have a map G, a map C from a group G to group of automorphism H. This map is a homomorphism, and in particular, we have an action of group G on the group H. When a map P from H to G is called a relative Rota-Baxter operator on H with respect to the action Ψ, if the following equality true. Here you can see that in the left-hand side, we have the product PHBK, as in the case of Rota-Baxter operator. But here we have the following element. Image under B, the product element H, and here automorphism Ψ sub BH acts on element K. This is the definition of relative Rota-Baxter operator and analog definition of Rota-Baxter group, so-called relative Rota-Baxter group, is the following. If we have B is a relative Rota-Baxter operator on H with respect to Ψ, when the quadruple H, G, Ψ, and B is said to be a relative Rota-Baxter group. You can see that in this case, we have two groups and two maps. For example, if we take H is equal to G, and Ψ is a homomorphism from the group G into the group of inner and automorphism, such that Ψ sub G is the conjugation by element G in power minus one. When we get the when the relative Rota-Baxter operator satisfy the following identity, And now you can see that this is the definition of usual Rutte-Baxter operator on group G. And we have a pair G and B is a Rutte-Baxter group. Hence, the relative Rutte-Baxter group is generalization of Rutte-Baxter group. And now I formulate some properties of this operator. It was proved in the same paper, and the properties are the following. Let H and G be group, and Psi is a homomorphism from a group G into the group of automorphism H. What is defined the action of G on H? When the map B from H to G is a relative Rutte-Baxter operator, if and only if the set of the following pair, B of H and H, is a subgroup of semi-direct product H and G. You can see that it's similar to the results which we have for Rutte-Baxter operator. And also you can see that the map B from the group H with a new operation circle sub B to G is a group homomorphism. And this group, it's isomorphic to our group of B. This is the set of pairs BH and H. And this isomorphism is defined by the following. Element H goes to this pair. Now I will say about our results, which we have found with my colleagues Tatiana Kozlovskaya, Pavel Sokolov, Ksenia Zimirova, and Matvey Zonov. This is preprint. Now we are working on this paper. And we have the following results. But and first I introduce some notation. B, it's a Rutte-Baxter operator on semi-direct product H and G. And we can consider the projection of this semi-direct product P sub H is projection to the first component, and P of G is projection to the second component. One of them, of course, it's a homomorphism, but the second one, it's only set theoretical moment. Let us consider the restriction. We will denote the restriction of B on the subgroup H. This is a map from H into the semi-direct product. We know a lot of different possibility for construction of Rutte-Baxter operators on semi-direct product. In particular, semi-direct product is possible to consider a exact factorization and so on. We have a lot of Rutte-Baxter operators on semi-direct product. And now we can formulate the following question. Is it possible to construct a relative Rutte-Baxter operator if we know usual Rutte-Baxter operator on semi-direct product? In opposite case, it's not difficult to prove. If you have some relative Rutte-Baxter operator, you can construct classical Rutte-Baxter operator on the semi-direct product. But in the opposite case, we prove the next theory. Let B, it's a map from the semi-direct product H and G to this semi-direct product, is a Rutte-Baxter operator such that the image of the restriction B on V on H and projection to the component H lies in the center of G. When the map, what is defined by the following, following composition, we take restriction of B on H and consider the projection to the component G, is relative rotabaxter operator on H with respect to action of G on H. This action is defined by this semi-direct product. This is connection of rotabaxter operator on semi-direct product and relative rotabaxter operator. And also we have example which shows that the construction of this theorem can map different rotabaxter operators on semi-direct product to the same relative rotabaxter operator. Formulated some results which can be proved independently in the in these two papers. The first paper is the paper of four Chinese mathematicians by Guo, Sheng, and Tang. And the second one is the paper of Indian mathematician Rafa and Mahender Singh. And in this article was proved the next theorem. Suppose that we have a relative rotabaxter group. It's H, G, C, and B. When if we take the set H with operation point and circle B, then we will have a skewless brace. The situation is similar. If we have rotabaxter group, then we can construct a skewless brace. And here, if we have relative rotabaxter group, then we also can construct a skewless brace. And we can formulate the natural question: is every skew left brace induced by a relative rotabaxter operator? And the answer on this question you can find in these two papers, and the result is the following. Let H point circle be a skew left brace, and lambda is a map from H circle to a group of automorphism of H with point, the associative lambda map, when the quadruple group G with point, also the group H with the circle lambda map, and identity map on H is a relative rotabaxter group. Furthermore, the skew left brace structure induced by the relative rotabaxter operator, which is identity on H, is the same H skew brace with operation point and circle. And now I'm going to the last part of my talk, is a post group Young-Baxter equation. I recall the definition of postgroup. This definition was defined in the paper of these four authors. This is new definition. It's similar to the definition of post-Lie algebra. The definition is the following. Let G be a group, and the triangle is a map from G, G square to G, when this this tuple G point and triangle is called a post group if the operator L sub A with operator from G to G what is defined by the formula with operator L A of B, it's the product of A triangle B, where A is fixed, but B is a variable. Variable is an automorphism on G. And for any A, B, and C, the following equality holds. You can see that this last axiom of post group is equivalent to the following axiom. It says that if we take composition one multiplication on element B, and the second one is multiplication of A, this is multiplication on this A. This is the definition of postgroup, and this author proved the next theorem. For any skewly brace, we can define the operation A circle B as lambda AP when G point and circle group. And in the opposite direction, for any post group, we can define the operation A circle B by the following rule when we have a skew-left brace. Hence, we have one-to-one map from post groups and skew-left braces. And now we can formulate the next question. Because we have some subsets of skew-left braces, so-called lambda homomorphic skew brace, and we can formulate the question. If G is a lambda homomorphic skew-left brace, what can we say about the corresponding post group and G with point and the triangle? And our paper with my colleagues, we have found the answer on this question. And the answer is the following. Let G with two operations be a lambda homomorphic skew left brace when the correspondence post group G with point and triangle has the following properties. First properties that the operation triangle is right distributive. It means that what this equation true. And the second axiom property say that if the associator of free element A, B, C, it's the following product. We consider the A triangle multiplied to B triangle C with this bracket. Now we change the bracket, take the inverse element, and we get associator. And the property that the associator of this free element A, B, C is equal to A triangle C. You can see that it does not depend on the element B. On the other side, the operator triangle is left distributive for any post group. Hence, we have a good description for the lambda homomorphic skew left brace and the correspondent post group. When we only started to study post groups, of course, we formulated the next question. What post group it's possible to construct using some fixed group. And we have found the answer on this question. We proved the next proposition. But for any group G, we can define the operation A circle B as conjugation of element B by element A, when this tuple is a post group. But you can see, if you know that this, if you define on a group G operation, what is conjugation when we get so-called quantum. A quantum is only some algebraic system, but also quantum you can define if you consider the conjugation not only element A, but element A, A in power n. And we formulated the question. If we define the operation triangle as conjugation by element A in power n, is it possible to construct post group? But in general case, the answer is no. And we proved the second part of our proposition for a two-step nilpotent group and element and n is integer number, which is not a zero. Let us define the operation n circle b as conjugation of element b by element a in power n when this tuple is a post group. This is some set of example different post groups, and from this proposition follows that if we have a two-step nilpotent group, when for any integer n where operations define a post group, and hence we can construct a left bridge with G with two operations which are defined by the following formula. This is some example, and now we have found some property of this skew brace and post group. The first property is the following. The group G with operation circle defined above is also a two-step nilpotent group. Because in general case, if you have some skew brace, when the group G with circle and group G with circle can be different. For example, it's possible to construct example where one group is abelian, but the second one contains non-abelian free groups. And the second property, the skew left brace is a lambda homomorphic skew brace. But for lambda homomorphic skew brace, we have a good description. We proved the next theorem that any lambda homomorphic skew brace is extension by one trivial skew brace by another trivial skew brace. And in some sense, we can say that any lambda homomorphic skew brace is metatrivial skew brace. And now we can construct solution for the braid equation. We put the next theorem. Let G be a two-step nilpotent group, and N is some integer number. When the map C from G square to G square defined by the following rules, B multiplied to the commutator in power N, here A multiplied to the commutator B and A in this power is a solution to the braid equation on the set G. See, now we have good description, good solution to the class of two-step nilpotent group. This class, it's understandable class of group. I think it's the second class after abelian group. And is it possible? At the end, I formulated the next problem. Because at the beginning of my talk, I told that if we have solution for the Young-Baxter equation or a braid equation, it's possible to construct invariant for not. But now I formulated the next problem. What not invariant? For classical knot, for virtual knot, for welded, and so on, it's possible to define using this solution. Now, that's all. Thank you for your attention.
Okay. Thank you. Any questions, comments? Okay, unfortunately, we cannot ask the questions from the BIMSA because in the auditory there are some problems with the microphone. Sorry. Any other questions? Maybe any other participants? No. So thank you again, and Valery, we will wait this presentation from you. Okay.
Okay. I will send my presentation.
Okay. Thank you. So we can.
Okay. Thank you for attention.
Okay. Okay.
Bye bye.
My sorry for the problems with the microphone.